the reason for government, the reason we institute government among us, right? Governments are instituted among us. Why? Because we need it to protect these liberties, not take these liberties away, and certainly not infringe on your right to defend. If your first law of nature is to be able to defend yourself, government's job is to protect that right, not infringe upon it and say, you can't carry here, you can't carry there, you can't protect your family in this situation, you only have so many rounds in your magazines. Whatever different ways government tries to infringe on it, that's the opposite of what government ought to be doing. It ought to be protecting your right to defend yourself.
So as today's society gets more agnostic, right, and farther away from that idea of laws of nature or laws of God, how do we institute that back in?
We encourage them to think like Benjamin Franklin. Okay, Benjamin Franklin was no Christian, all right? But he was not an atheist. He still believed there was a God, but he wasn't a Christian. But he still said, he looked at the Founding Fathers, and he even said right there at the Constitutional Convention, he said, look, how could we possibly form a nation without the Supreme Being, without the Father of Lights illuminating our understanding? So even as someone that was really considered the least religious of all the Founding Fathers, he said, I've studied every government in the history of man, and I've studied every religion. And I know that if we institute these Christian principles, the idea of the laws of nature, we'll have a more free society.
Sure.
So even when you don't necessarily believe in a particular religion, understand that according to the Founding Fathers, you need a religion to have morality, you need a morality to have liberty. So if liberty's your aim, if you want freedom, then you gotta have that formula in place as a culture overall in order to get that result.